Thank you. strong, mutually beneficial relationships with Indigenous peoples of our region and with the First Nations of the state of North Dakota. Thank you and enjoy the ceremony.
Thank you. Our guest speaker today and a member of the North Dakota State Board of Higher Education is Katina Byde. And Vice President of Academic Affairs is Kim Gray.
We'd like to recognize a few important groups of attendees today. First, could all the faculty of Williston State College please rise? Thank you, faculty, for your commitment to educating our graduates and helping them pave the way for this day. Without you and your passion to educate, this day would not be possible. Next, would all the staff of Williston State College please rise? They're all over the gym. Thank you, staff, for your tireless dedication in assisting our students to be successful in reaching graduation status. And finally, for those that are able to do so, would the family members and friends of the graduating class please rise? I have only one question
for each of you today. What's next? What's next is the only question I have for you. For some of you, this is the end of the road for your academic journey, as your degree or certificate from Williston State College is all you need. For others, this is but the first step in your academic journey. They may last several years. Earlier this week, I sent an email to the coaches for our six sports, as well as another email to the student body, asking for any sophomore graduates that care to do so to share with me where they're going to college after today. I received about 40 total responses from our graduating class, students or student athletes, as well as non-student athletes. And I'd like to share a few of those with you. First of all, let's talk about our student athletes. In the fall season with volleyball program, Ms. Isabel Evans is going to be heading to the University of Alaska Anchorage to continue her career in volleyball. Also, a young lady who is a two-sport athlete for the Tetons, played both basketball as well as volleyball, is heading to the University of Minnesota Crookston to play volleyball and pursue a degree in exercise science. Ms. Cindy Levesque. Three athletes from the hockey team are moving on to play at the next level. First of all, the young gentleman who worked the daytime hours at the welcome desk in Stevens Hall, Mr. Thomas Patterer, is heading to Gustavo Adolphus in Minnesota. Two hockey players are heading to Waldorf University in Iowa. They are Mr. Campbell Jackson and Mr. Wayne Ojay. Also in the winter sports, women's basketball. We have two sophomores that are heading on to play at the next level. The first one has a number of offers that she's still contemplating as to which one to select, and that is Ms. Brooklyn Douglas. And the other is heading to Alabama to pursue a degree in kinesiology. And she has been recruited and will be playing for the Division II School of Auburn University in Montgomery, Alabama, Ms. Keely Teedy. All right, let's end with the spring sports. Let's start with softball. On the softball team, two sophomores are moving on to play at the next level. The first one going to the University of Health Sciences and Pharmacy in St. Louis, Missouri, to pursue biomedicine, Ms. Allison Nyquist. And the second student athlete headed to Eureka College is Claire Morris. Is baseball. As you've been following, baseball is on the way to Miles City to play in a regional tournament tomorrow. We wish you the best of luck. Over 30 wins on the season and more wins to come. They have nine. Yeah, go ahead, please. There are nine student athletes moving on to play at the next level. They are to Eureka College, Mr. Garrett Foggin. Two gentlemen are heading to Northwest Missouri State. They are Mr. Brady Miles and Mr. Jackson Meyer. Headed to the University of Fort Lauderdale, to get away from the snow, Mr. Josh Tibbs. On to Emmanuel College in Florida, in Georgia, Mr. Clayton McAllister. On to Morningside University in the state of Iowa, Mr. Logan Worthington. Heading to Campbellsville University in Kentucky, Mr. Colby Freeland. Heading to the College of Idaho, Mr. Jordan Kelly. And the last one, staying fairly close to home, heading to an excellent program at Naval State University, Mr. Derek Palmer. Now for the non-student athletes. I had about 20 responses in this bucket, and of those responses, five of you are headed to UND. Five of you are headed to Dickinson State University, three of you are headed to North Dakota State University, and a small handful of you are headed out of state. A couple of the out-of-state my moms, dads, friends, family members, even little ones at the very walker up on stage pinning the graduates. And as the president of this college, it made me incredibly proud for that nursing program, knowing that those individuals are going out to the hospitals in this part of the country, and they're going to provide excellent, top-notch service to all the patients that they come in contact with. So to those 28 nursing students, I say congratulations and good luck in the future to you guys.
And to close my remarks, I turn back to the graduates. Well done. We're very proud of you. Carry your Teton diploma with you and your experience at Williston State College with you proudly as you continue on with your life and your academic journey. We are extremely proud of what you have accomplished. Thank you for having been a part of our lives.
Good morning. I would like to recognize any former faculty or faculty emeritus that we currently have. I don't know if anyone showed up today. I didn't see. If you're here, please stand. All right. I don't see anyone. We do have one current faculty member that I'd like to recognize. I'm going to try to read this without choking up. So those of you that know, I'm a boob. Mr. Lance Olson is retiring from Williston State College. He has been instrumental in my experience here, and I'm not going to get through this, Lance. It's terrible. You shouldn't let me read it. So, Assistant Professor of Math and Science, Mr. Lance Olson, has announced his retirement from full-time teaching at Williston State College. Mr. Olson has an outstanding teaching record that spans more than 3 decades. His scholarly achievement is top-notch, and his service, I can't see it anymore, have far exceeded standard expectations. During his career, Mr. Olson would model teaching excellence on a daily basis. With a teaching career that has risen to such a high level of excellence, Mr. Olson checks all the requirements to be considered for faculty emeritus. Emeritus status is an honor conferred by the college to show respect for a distinguished career. The emeritus status states that even though you are no longer an official part of this organization, you have shown such merit that we claim you as a continuing part of our professional group. We gather glory from your reflected glory. That being said, with support of the Faculty Senate of Williston State College, it is Dr. Herning and my pleasure to honor you and bestow on you Faculty Emeritus. Could you please come forward, Mr. Olson? I tried.
Please help me welcome Brooklyn Douglas. leave my home, and experience change. So that's exactly what I did. I left and went to Montana to experience something new. I was gone one semester. One semester was all it took for me to appreciate my hometown and the community I was. My point is, things change. Life changes, and so much happens that we would never expect. Our minds change, our majors change, and things rarely go as planned. In fact, statistics show that 80% of people change their major in college education. So why are we all trying to plan so far out in our future? Why aren't we just focusing on what we can do? Start living in now, especially with the people you love, because you never know when they may not be here. Do what is important to you now, and do it. We can trust about where our life will be in 5 years, but more than likely, plans will change with time. So live in the now and live for today. We can do everything right. We can prepare for things to happen or not happen, but life is still going to take its path. If we spend so much time dwelling on what is going to happen or even in the past, we are missing what's right in front of us. For many of us, we all have someone that can help you here today, that we would do anything for them to be. But what about the people that are in our lives now? We never know when we might get the phone call and someone very dear to us is taken too soon. That is why my advice to you today is live in the moment and live with the people that surround us. Don't take life or anyone for granted. Don't take the relationships you made and the lessons you learned because they happen for a reason. Be thankful for the friends, teachers, and family that you have. So much has changed in my life from attending Williston State College. From my career, to my attitude, and my mindset, because I challenged myself to live in the now. Our mission statement at Williston State College is where the people make the difference. And I challenge all of you, as you drive 3 hours home, or fly across the world, to live for the now and be the difference. Thank you for the opportunity to stand before you, and most importantly, thank you to the people of Williston State College that made the difference.
Thank you, Brooklyn. It's now my pleasure to introduce Jenny Neal, who will bring greetings to today's students. Jenny is originally from Wyoming, but graduated from high school in Williston. Today, Jenny is graduating with an Associate of Arts, Associate of Applied Science in Business Management. While Jenny has started at Williston State, she was very comfortable that it wasn't one of her top five schools, but it worked out for the best that she ended up there. While at WSC, Jenny was involved in Phi Theta Kappa, Phi Beta Lambda, and worked as a supplementary instructor. She is grateful for the Williams County Scholarship that allowed her to get a solid educational foundation before moving on to her next institution. She truly feels well prepared to continue her education in business management at Dickinson State University next year. Please help me welcome Jenny Neal.
Good morning, and thank all of you for being here today to celebrate the Williston State College class of 2022. As many of you heard from Brooklyn's speech, the mission of Williston State College is where the people will make the difference. It sounds cliche, but I have found that this saying has more meaning to it than I imagined. That is why I would like to take some time this morning to thank the people who made the difference for me while attending Williston State College. To all of the professors I have, each and every one of you embody the mission of this college. I can count on you to help guide me through assignments, make the content engaging, support me with my in and out of class endeavors, and a lot of you opened up several doors for me that led to some amazing opportunities. It's been wonderful getting to know all of you, even the professors I didn't have or didn't get to know as well. The small how's it going in the halls show that you care about the students you teach and those who don't. I'm going to miss having each of you teach me, but rest assured I will take everything and my experiences here with me for the rest of my life. So thank you. To all of my friends, those I've made at Williston State College, and those who have stuck with me while I attended here. Whether you know it or not, things got really difficult in my personal life. You've all been an amazing support system and are all amazing friends. I truly could not have gotten through this without you, so thank you. And lastly, but definitely not least, to all of my family. Thank you to everyone who traveled this weekend to be here and watch my mom and I walk across the stage. It means the world to me that you're here. But most importantly, I want to thank my mom, my dad, and my brother. You've been with me through the late nights when I was silent student and you could slack on my tours, every breakdown where I felt like my school life was getting to me too much, and you calmed me down and reassured me that everything was going to be okay. And mom, you and I have shared this college experience together. We could sympathize with each other on assignments and ask to come to college, which only made our relationship stronger. Today, we are at that finish line. You and I get to walk across this stage today and close this chapter. I love you, and I am so proud of you, so proud of us. And thank you for being so supportive throughout this journey. And lastly, to the graduates here. All of the people I thanked before made a difference in my life throughout the 2 years at Williston State College. But I know each of you have your own list of people who helped you along your college journey. One of the biggest lessons I've learned here is how important people are, and how we often forget to thank them and let them know that they are appreciated. I hope that all of you can learn what I did and tell the people in your life how much they matter. Because again, both here at Williston State College and everywhere else in your life, it is very true that the people will make a difference. Thank you all for your time, and congratulations to all of the graduates.
Dedication and fortitude to a better future. We are here. your calling, wherever it is. Thank you for placing your trust in this institution and in our system. The same Board of Higher Ed serves to shape policy and pathways to offer as many opportunities as possible for student success. We can do that work, but it's you, the graduates, who have had to reach out to explore and to grab hold of that future as you're moving forward. So your presence here today reminds everyone, you, your friends, your family, your professors, your naysayers, that you indeed are successful. Your dedication, innovation, optimism, and most of all, your grit, determination, and fortitude have transformed today into a major milestone. And I think that we should give you another round of applause.
Thank you. Taylor Peterson.
Thank you.
Allie Garber.
Jacob Blackledge.
Madison Gudbeck.
Harmony Smith.
Joshua P. Terrell.
Thank you.